All right, welcome back to Hippo Cup 7, group stage, Sunday, day two. We are heading back to group H for the second time for a matchup between Let's Get K-BBQ and Cowabunga. This is a B seed versus a D seed, so you would typically anticipate these to not be always that competitive, but you never know, because this Cowabunga team is not bad.
They are not bad. This is conveniently my group, and Cowabunga has conveniently played a match today.
Conveniently against your team?
Conveniently against my team. They played quite well on some maps. They took a point, put one up on Marisa there with a pretty decent team score. That's against the A seed in the group. We are now on a matchup against the B seed in this group. Well, I would also say is probably on par with the A seed in this group. Quite strong in terms of players and names. The question is, how many of them show up for this match and how motivated are for this? I am not sure. And I think that's kind of the question in group stages, right? The A and B seeds tend to maybe chill out a little bit more, and the C and D seeds are ones that are really kind of pushing for the spots here. Unfortunately for Cowabunga, taking that loss this morning means that they cannot lose this match. Otherwise, they forfeit their spot in bracket stage in Hippo Cup 7. So they do need to win this match regardless of how Let's Get K-BBQ is playing.
Yeah, this is going to be our first sighting of Let's Get K-BBQ, of course, and very curious to see kind of how that team performs. They've got some very good players for being not an A seed. They're actually the bottom of the B seed, if that matter. So excited to see how they perform. We've got yet another Nomad 2 ban coming out. This is
real.
And quite frequently. Nomad 1 to follow up, so getting rid of some aim here. I want to look, bring the ref sheet back up here. What were the bans and picks for Cowabunga earlier? They banned Hard Rock 3, Hard Rock 1 before. And they picked Freemod 3, DT3, DT5. So they were picking kind of tapping stuff, it seems. See if they do the same thing against Let's Get K-BBQ. I'm not sure if they'll be adjusting their strategy at all.
Yeah, very interesting in terms of how they're going to have to shift that with the speed roster, I feel like, that New York has. On this team, I said, it is a New York team. I'm going to refer to them as New York because this is United States Cup.
USC, but with teams of nine.
Exactly. This is USC if it was a dystopian future. There are a lot of tapping players on this roster, or at least players that are even capable of playing tapping, right? I mean, you've got Taquito to captain off the roster here. You've got Opixe, who is a known tapping DT stream style player. Twilight, who is also a stream player. Nemrose, who I didn't actually even know was New York, who happens to be a speed player. Arco, who happens to be a, who guessed it, speed player. Emerald Ages, I think, is the first break from this, just based on rank alone. Not quite maybe matching up to the same thing. They're more of a hidden player, unironically, I think. So I feel like that's maybe a bit of a shift there. Pez, they're everything player, unironically. Like, Pez is just really good at the game.
What is that, rhythm?
That's rhythm game.
Yeah.
So they're just really good at most things. Yeah. Toki, really good at most things, but speed player. Yeah. And then there's Freddy Benson, speed player. So don't pick DT into this team. Don't pick Freemod 3 into this team. Avoid everything that is...
Don't pick anything.
Mechanics.
Yeah.
Avoid all mechanics. So your remaining picks are Freemod 2 and Freemod 4. Good luck.
Problem is that they are also good at those things because they have, like, you know, Taquito and Arco and Rhythm Game.
That's true.
And it's going to be DT4 first pick for Let's Get K-BBQ.
Speed map.
So we'll get into Ghost of Lorelei first pick. Well, there's that high BPM stuff and that tapping stuff. Coming right off the bat, right out of the gate.
Highest BPM map in the pool, 270. That is the highest BPM map by a 20, I think, almost. So, pretty good speed going on here for Let's Get K-BBQ. On the side of Cowabunga, I guess it serves to mention their roster a little bit here as well. Got a couple known players on this team. I think the two that should stick out to most people pretty readily are Ofiz and Jacob 3. I think they're the two that show up the most often. I believe Ofiz being probably the best Irish tournament player by a decent margin now. Jacob 3 being one of, if not the best player in Washington, pretty consistently in United States Cup usually. Easy Chalk, great player as well, maybe a little bit less tournament experienced than others on this roster, but still nice. The good part about this right now, though, is that Jacob 3 is here, and Jacob 3 was not here this morning for their first match, which I think will make a pretty decent difference if he's playing well, because they had good scores without him. So
yeah, Jacob 3 is going to be important. That dude is really, really solid. The problem is that I think, like, let's get KBBQ. Just, like, the top end of their roster is so, so strong as well. Like, they definitely match even with Cowabunga playing well with Jacob 3. You've got some players who are going to be very scary on just about everything. Takedo, obviously a multi-time WBC champion at this point. Freddie Benson, who's been number one in the world in the past. And, you know, so we'll get into it and we'll see how this goes. First pick, let's get KBBQ. Hidden on Toki and Takedo, DT only on Nemiraz, Freddie Benson. Hidden on Lunasa and Daitabi Helios. And DT only on Ofiz and Faker 3, as we call him.
Yes.
And
I'm interested to see how de-rusted Toki is, honestly. Not a name I have seen.
No, I know. It's been a while since I've seen him kind of as a regular part of the tournament community, but, you know, New York player, New York team. Makes sense.
And this is his skill set, so you should be... It's chilly on this
Yeah,
map.
Do you remember We Love Llama a couple years
oh,
ago?
Oh, I do. Oh, I do. That forced a bracket reset into the longest grand finals that Hippo Cup has ever seen.
Best of 15 bracket reset grand final. Let's go.
Yeah, and they were both, like, really long matches, too. Like, they went, like, within 2 or 3 points of tiebreak on the second one.
Well, there's an early break from Nemiraz. Going to be advantage Cowabunga, as they still have 4 FCs on the board against now 3 for, let's get KBBQ. Lunasa, though, going to follow it up with first break for Cowabunga.
Not bad. It's pretty good, though. That is a good 300,000 score bonus for Lunasa over Nemiraz there, which is not a huge margin. Jacob 3 missing, however, is going to absolutely throw this over. That's 3 FCs now to 2, and there goes Daitaku, and this map may have just come to a close.
Yeah, it's just Ofiz left. Halfway through, you've still got a triple FC on Let's Get KBBQ. You've got Nemiraz with a built-up bit of support combo for them all, but really, you're just looking at the 3 FCs against 1. And that lead is going to go pretty quickly. Let's get KBBQ. I mean, this is their skill set. You expect them to do well on this, and they are fulfilling expectations.
They are quite good at this, yes. Freddie Benson with the ACK, 99.84. It's not really much to break on at the ending if you haven't broken at the beginning, you know, barring the traditional whoops, I missed type pattern. I think most of these players should be pretty comfortable now if they were comfortable earlier. Takedo and Toki, both of those hidden double timed FCs still upstanding. Ofiz is definitely the best speed player on Cowabunga. It makes a heck of a lot of sense that he is the one to be holding the combo right now. Most of these other players on here on Cowabunga are not speed players. There goes Takedo. So it's only going to be 2 FCs maximum for Let's Get KBBQ, but still not quite enough for Cowabunga to be able to make this turn around. A little bit too far, too gone in these last few seconds here, but a good recovery, actually, from everyone that missed.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of combo coming into the end here. Just not a lot you can do when there's a double FC with that kind of accuracy like Freddie Benson has. I think that's 1-100. Very, very good stuff from him. Mm-hmm. And, 9 million point victory for Let's Get KBBQ. Just a solid score from a team that you would expect to get a good score on this map from. And you're not going to be too worried about that one if you're Cowabunga. Like, hey, yeah, okay, we lost the other team's first pick that's in their skill set. Whoop-de-doo. And you move on, you go into your own first pick, and just keep going.
They are chilling right now. First pick for Cowabunga in the previous match was Tempestissimo. I doubt they're going to go straight back into that one. While they didn't have a bad team score, they did not put up a single FC on it. So I imagine that, especially against the tapping team, they're probably not going to be running into that same skill set. And I think the hard part for Cowabunga, after picking so many speed maps earlier today in the match, like literally every single pick that they had was a DT map, is that they can't do that in this match. So they need to completely shift their strategy. If I was them, you know, I would have potentially used the match this morning to maybe branch out the skill sets a little bit, maybe touch on a couple of different things that we know that our other two opponents are probably not going to be, you know, as good at. Like, it made sense for the A seed this morning because the A seed team in this group is not in as inherently good at DT maps.
Y'all are not a raw speed team.
Yeah, definitely not like the raw speed team. Like, if you took the B seed versus the A seed, there is one team that's better at speed. I think the mechanics are equal, but like the fast stuff is where it starts to drop. So in this match, I don't know what happens. It's Nomad 4.
Fortunately, not a whole lot of raw speed in this pool anyway, but yeah, Nomad 4, like you said, I mean, going to something not raw mechanics for Cowabunga. The problem is, I don't know. Like, I feel like Let's Get KBBQ can still do just fine on a map like this. Like, you've got Takedo, who's just gonna absolutely obliterate this sort of thing. And I mean, whoever else is in, probably, you know, and I'm in early stage pool. I think they've got like a strong roster for basically any pick.
Yeah, I mean, I'm thinking for this roster, I'm envisioning Arco coming in for something like this. Definitely his type of skill set. Pez is also a potential for something like this. Last would either be, in my mind, like a Twilight or... No, I think it might be Twilight. I'm going to say Twilight, Arco, Pez are probably the best three for them, in my mind, on this map. You know, and that's... I guess that's technically not counting in who would be playing Hidden. That's, like, in a perfect world who would be playing this map, I feel like. There's Twilight. Emerald Ages seems to be one of the ones. And there's Arco. Okay, so it looks like we'll be switching out the Pez for the Emerald Ages on this one. Potentially, I don't know who runs Hidden on this.
I don't know anything about Emerald Ages as a player. I only ever see him as in staff. So I have no idea what he's like as an actual tourney player. We'll get to find out, I suppose.
I recognize the name. Like, yeah.
Yeah. I think he refs a lot.
Looks like he played... looks like they got third in Kanyo Cup D2.
That's not too bad.
A couple back, so not bad. Yeah, not a bad performance. They're going to be the Hidden player on this one, so it looks like they might be just running Arco and Twilight for those guaranteed combos potentially here for them. Cowabunga, the Hidden on Majora McQueen and Rico Elf. Wappy's going to find a really early break, but Arco's going to trade that one out. So pretty even here at the start. A little bit of
wait for the slider stream.
Yeah, the one thirds will demolish people.
All right, what's going to happen here? Emerald Ages, Arco, Majora McQueen, and Daitaku Helios all breaking there.
Emerald's fine.
Emerald did not miss. Yeah, okay, so we got three FCs on Let's Get KBBQ and just one on Cowabunga. So decent-sized combo lead for the New York team. There goes Takedo, surprisingly, however.
Interesting. Wait, Emerald Ages?
Okay, well, Recoil missed as well, though, so it's not going to be the worst.
Yeah, I mean, Twilight is going to be able to keep this very handedly by himself. Emerald Ages and Arco both going to trade out with Ricoel. That's going to start to become a problem if someone can't hold a combo aside from Twilight. Majiro is going to make it a little bit easier here. Fluffy is basically just matching up to Takedo. Arco completely misreads that slider. And Daitaku now has to be the savior for Cowabunga, hoping that Twilight finds a miss here. But with 99% accuracy at this stage in the map, I imagine he is far too comfortable to be finding a miss. Maybe through all the hard stuff.
Yeah, this is looking pretty good for Let's Get KBBQ trying to get this early breakpoint. We need to be a miss from Twilight, and Fluffy and Daitaku Helios would both have to hold, and it's not going to be happening as Fluffy does break along with Recoil again. Daitaku Helios putting forth a pretty good combo here. It's just the problem is he's like relatively close to being matched by Takedo, and then you've got Twilight on the FC still.
Well, good performance from Twilight. This is what we kind of expected from him on this map. Cowabunga not quite matching up to that team score that they probably wanted here. Daitaku Helios just breaking combo right at the ending there, but highest score on their team. Nothing you can do against an 8 million plus score from Twilight, though. That is more than enough to hold this one down. That is actually almost going to be a 1v4 from Twilight at the ending of this map. Does miss the last pattern, but that is 1.5 million off from a 1v4.
Yeah, that's a really good score. Yeah, it's 2v4 with him and anyone else. Just not the best performance from Cowabunga. It's kind of shocking that that was their own pick and they didn't get a score above, like, barely above 4 million. So,
I wonder why Jacob Free didn't play that map.
I don't know. Is he a tech player?
I don't know. It just seems like something you'd be good at, maybe. I don't know. I'm theorizing. He's the GOAT, so I just kind of assume he, like, plays almost every map in my mind, I feel like. But very, very good score from Daitaku. 588 combo, just coming up short of you know, kind of breaks where most other people, I think, have found breaks on this map. So nothing to be ashamed of there. His teammates not quite coming up as close. So definitely need some more help into these future picks here. Going to start to get dangerous if KBBQ picks up their own pick here, which I imagine they will. There's plenty of speed left.
Yeah, this is like you can go DT1, DT2, DT3, CD5, Fremont 3. Like you've got all sorts of options in this particular position for them. Yeah, it's gonna be Nomad 5, so they're gonna switch it up. It's gonna go Nomad Reading instead, which is cool. I have not seen this map yet on stream, and I'm glad to do so now.
They're just gonna assert their dominance over the entire pool. Madhead Love. I guess this does make sense, right? You know, if you don't have an explicit reading player on your roster, you will have a very bad time on this map. And especially against a team like Let's Get KBBQ, who has at least two people who I know can absolutely play this map no issue. You know, this is actually a smart play from KBBQ here, right? Like, this is not just gimmick. This is reading with the overlaps. So if Cowabunga doesn't have a reading player, go in for it, right?
Yeah. Oh, you know what? I just realized I've been thinking that I hadn't seen this on stream, but I think we did see it the one time in the Old Navy match, didn't we?
We did see an FC, I think.
I just remembered that this map was on stream for that match now. It's been pretty rare on stream, but we did have that one. Yeah, I mean, you're Let's Get Part KBBQ, you've got Taquito for this, right? Who's, like, very, very good at this sort of map. Not sure who their other two are going to be. I don't know. Does Toki play this, actually?
Toki can do reading, I think. I imagine maybe, like, as a hidden player, I feel like, just to give some of the other players a better time with the Nomad. Pez makes sense here. And it looks like Emerald Aegis is going to be the lower BPM player for them today. Didn't do half bad on Nomad 4 with the hidden.
We'll see if Nomad 5 also can go well for Let's Get KBBQ as a team. Trying to consolidate the breakpointington.
Surely. Surely Cowabunga brings this one out.
Ophis, Easy Shock, Mitra, McQueen, Recoil. Doable. Excuse me. It is very doable, but whoa. That was weird.
Huh.
I don't know what happened on Recoil's screen there for a second. Don't know what happened to Mitra McQueen, who appears to have just completely missed everything at the start, but there goes Taquito as well. What's happening?
This map is just unplayable. This map is just not
That's
playable.
That's the hardest map in the pool.
It may be one of the hardest maps in the pool. Like, unironically, this map is quite difficult.
The skill set thing, because I feel like this is easy if you can play the, like, AR, but it's very hard if not. You know, it's kind of a polarizing skill set.
Kinda, yeah.
There's
Especially
the with Hidden. There's Mejuro, there goes Taquito had already gone, Toki went. So we've got Pez, Emerald Aegis, and Easy Chalk after Ophiz breaks one of the two remaining FCs for Cowabunga.
Easy Chalk could hold this down, potentially.
Yeah, absolutely. But he needs some help. Whatever form that help may take.
This is where it'll start, though. You're going to have to see the performance in this section here. Ajiro, unfortunately, not finding it. There's another break on the side of Cowabunga.
Easy Shock does break. It's traded with Toki, but that's far worse for Cowabunga than for Let's Get KBBQ. Taquito breaks again as well. I guess I shouldn't have said he was so good at this. The pressure. Yeah, I really did think he would be fine. I don't know. Ophiz with another break as well as Mejuro McQueen. It's down to just Recoil with 300 and change combo. Meanwhile, Pez and Emerald Aegis still holding. Pez with some interesting accuracy, but it doesn't really matter because the combo is there and they're up by 3 million.
Something here, potentially to give this up a little bit.
Emerald Aegis gone. Mejuro McQueen, Recoil, and Ophiz all gone as well. It's Easy Shock with some combo, Pez with the FC. I mean, this is just players not having a great time, unfortunately.
He's holding rough accuracy on the full combo from Let's Get KBBQ, but it's still standing, and that's what matters here. Major is going to find another break, and it's just Easy Shock with a semi-decent combo. Recoil and Ophiz really aren't doing too much here. Majiro continuing, and there goes Easy Chalk. I think that's just going to be it regardless of what happens. Pez, you can break now. It's okay. You've done enough.
Nah, he wants to pull up the 92 AC FD, bro. Yeah.
Oh, there he goes. Bypass.
Wait, there's no combo left at all on Let's Get K-Barbecue. They're up by 6 million, though, so I don't think it should matter. Opiz and Recoil only have a combined, like, 700 combo, so... Okay. I think they can bring back 5 million.
Man, Pez missed and then just went home. I don't know. He's like missed like 7 times since that first.
Wait, he's
missed.
Not home already?
Where's he? Apparently not. Probably from the basement. I don't know.
Let's Get K-Barbecue is not having a good time with the last part of this map. Fortunately for them, it doesn't really matter. Recoil's doing his best, but it's just too big of a gap.
So many breaks at this ending section.
Yeah, that section was really brutal for basically everyone. Wow. Yeah, it's just nothing. There's no combo on the board anywhere. The biggest combo is 120.
I love it. This is peak performance, believe it or not. I'm just enjoying the song now, unfortunately, for Cowabunga. Map is down and out here. Emerald Mage is holding a combo into the ending. It was already over, but there it is, a 5 million score gap in favor of Let's Get KBBQ and Cowabunga now with their potentially their final pick.
Yeah, geez, if they drop another break point, it's just match point. Let's Get KBBQ, huh? Not good for Cowabunga here. And now you've lost a tech map. You've lost a kind of speedy map. You've lost a low AR reading map. Like, what do you even try to pick into here? I don't actually know. Also, what's crazy, Pez finished with second worst miscount on the team, despite having that big 900 combo.
I love that from him.
That section near the end was really not good to him, unfortunately.
I love that from Pez.
I genuinely, like, I don't know what you pick here.
Cowabunga. Hard Rock may be like one of Let's Get KBBQ's lesser skill sets, but I don't think it's Cowabunga's.
We could just go free mode one.
Potentially.
I mean let's get KBBQ banned no mod one. Not a whole lot of aim in this pool.
Free mod two is a pretty easy map. Find some slip ups maybe. See what they end up going for. This could be their final stand, depending on how this next one goes. Twilight says, "Fear him." I don't know who him is, but I do fear him.
Fear him?
I'm afraid.
I don't know.
Going in.
Nomad 6 is going to be the pick. That is, Wait.
Okay.
The Oaxpie map. Hail Turquoise. We have not seen much of this one. I don't remember the last time I actually watched this being played, and yet somehow it's been picked 5 times, so skill issue on my part, I guess.
This is a tapping map.
They're all tapping maps.
This is just streams with stack sliders.
The secret is that they're just all tapping maps.
It's all tapping. It's always been tapping.
Always has been, yeah.
Yeah. I don't know how I feel about this pick, like, on principle, just because of the tapping roster that Let's Get KBBQ possesses, but I also understand that being in Cowabunga's position, there's really not much you can do right now except hope that they find a slip up, right? Because at this point, it's just been less about how Cowabunga has been performing and the fact that Let's Get KBBQ has just had pretty good scores across the board, so there's less for them to just be able to tackle here.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I don't know. I don't really know what the strategy is, and you're in this position for that team, so. You know, it's sad. This is not directly related, but 314 has a grand total of 3 picks or bans out of, like, 18 or whatever matches. Like, that's it. It's been banned once and picked twice. That's all.
It's a fairly, like, straightforward map, I feel like. In terms of styling, there's not a whole lot that can happen on that pick, and I think a lot of teams opt out of touching that for that reason. Like, there's so much. It's almost like avoiding a nomad one kind of in sense, where, like, you don't actually know what's going to happen on the pick because, you know, one break could decide it, or everyone could, like, not FC because it's so awkward. But that's what I've seen.
Yeah. Well, in we go. It's going to be Pez Arco on... Wait, Arco may not have no fail. I'm not sure if that's just the client.
Well, we'll see.
It might just be the client. The score is right, so it's just the client.
Streamer, can we get a window reset for Arco? Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you. Love to see it. There it is.
I feel like this glitch has been happening a lot this weekend.
It has, quite frequent. Miss from Lunasa pretty early. It's, you know, we're good. Love it. Love to see it. I was going to say, there's no way someone's missing here.
Four-way against four-way.
Lucky guy. Messes up the finger control, though. Missed that rhythm change. That's a big first break. But Tokido's trying to drop on the hidden.
Emerald Age is the next to break as well. And it's 3FCs to 2 now for Kawabunga. Just with the Dr. Word here. There go Pez and Toki again. And it's just Arco against Recoil and Ophiz on double FC for Kawabunga. We talked about Let's Get Barbecue being good at this sort of, you know, tapping stuff. But surprisingly, no Taquito in for this. And the members who are here having a little trouble.
With Lunasa, it's Recoil and Ophiz. Those two players are pretty strong at this skill set here. And they've just got Arco to fend off. Now Fluffy doing a good job of recovering that combo after that very early break. Arco having a heck of a lot of trouble in the latter part of this map here. Ooh, Toki and Emerald Age is not too much better with the hidden.
Yeah, that's
this is it.
That's a double FC? That's a double FC for Kawabunga on Recoil and on Ophiz. Well done to them. They get on the board 3-1 down. I am kind of not sure why Taquito wasn't in for that, if I'm being honest, but it wouldn't really have mattered by the looks of things. Actually, yeah, it wouldn't have mattered.
This
6 million, give or take, and they lost by 6 million, so he wouldn't have been able to make a big enough difference.
Two matches in a row for Kawabunga where they have gone down 0-3 and then won a pick. So, I don't know what they've got locked in on this fourth pick, but they've got it locked in.
Yeah, I don't know. And in the earlier match, it was a break point as well, right? So
yeah.
Of course, that was a bit of a troll pick on the all hidden on.
Hey. That was technique. Just bad technique. But a good point on the board for Kawabunga. They will not be getting swept in any of their matches so far. They are rocking out the 1 point at the minimum. Match is not over yet. Let's Get KBBQ could potentially, and I imagine they will win their own pick here given how their strategy has gone so far, but it does give Kawabunga the chance to potentially get 2 points on the board here if they find a confident pick after this.
Yeah, I mean, it's tricky for sure. What do we have left? Oh, it's just DT5. I was going to say there's still like a bunch of DTs left for Let's Get KBBQ to choose from if they want to do that, and they do indeed. Do exactly that.
This is smart from Let's Get KBBQ, right? If you start to take advantage of the fact that Kawabunga played a lot of DTs in the other match and you know that you're pretty good at DT, and if you take one look at Kawabunga's team score on this map, you know that you will win this. Rough team performance on this one from them. Sub 10 million across the entire team. Best performer was Fluffy, who still put up a 2-miss, dropped about 200 combo before the ending of the map. Two players at sub 2 million, one player almost at sub 1 million. So, you know,
not
amazing there. The score gap on this map in the previous match was almost 15 million. So, good potential here for Let's Get KBBQ. I mean, I guess that's assuming Let's Get KBBQ gets a really good team score, because that 15 mil score difference is majorly in part due to a triple FC, but I don't know how many teams are going to triple FC this map. It could be. I haven't seen a lot of triple FCs.
No. I feel like we haven't seen a whole ton of just FCs in general. Like, it's been kind of hit or miss on those. Not like previous group stages.
Yeah, nobody has SS'd this map this weekend, too. Like, even just on a singular. Willy, I think, has the highest ACK on this of the weekend with a 1-100. Which is kind of nasty.
Yeah, that's really insane.
That's 1-100 is nasty.
It makes me almost want to do stats, but, like, stats for Scorby1 just seems so, like, not
top
great, you know?
Yeah.
Well, let's see how we do here. We've got some players on both sides who should do well in this type of map, much like most of the maps in this pool. So over to see if we can go over to Let's Get KBBQ, avoid giving up a break point after Kawabunga did get on the board with their own pick as we try to load in. We'll get there, I promise, one day. There we are. Well, we're going to be doing a little of this, actually. Here we go. Let everybody catch up.
Interested to see the potential improvements from Cowabunga out of this pick here, and whether or not Let's Get KBBQ is confident, because I guess it's two parts, right? Because you can't expect teams to always perform the exact same. You know, you could have a really bad run across a couple players here, so Cowabunga could do better. I guess it's just, I think the thing that will really decide this map is how strong KBBQ looks on this map.
Oh, there goes Metro McQueen, so we'll see what that improvement ends up looking like. But with Metro breaking and Pofi breaking at the start, there goes Tokyo, that's first miss from Let's Get KBBQ. Improvement might be coming. Improvement might be coming. Seeing some pretty decent scores so far from Cowabunga. The act is a little suspect, though. 96 on Puffy, 95 on Lunasa.
Yeah, Lunasa was the second lowest score on their team with the hidden double time in the first playthrough. They actually switched out Ricoel for Meiji Ro, who looks to be doing a little bit better right now. Gotta hit these back and forth. Takedo and Lunasa both trade Meiji that.
As well.
That's two FCs to two right now, but they need one of these combos to break on KBBQ in order to even out the fact that Toki has a big combo. And there goes Freddy!
Alright, so you've got Toki on the... or no, you've got... What do we have? We have Opixe on the FC and Toki on the big combo? Yeah. Well, I have a big combo, just a decent combo. So, unfortunately, I mean, it's a double FC, but not a lot of backing combo for Cowabunga, so this is going to come slowly. Because actually, it's not even a double FC, right? It's like minus 40 combo. And there goes Easy Shock on the slow part. Yikes.
What? Why? Why did you miss? What was there?
He had hope for you, and then you just threw the hope away. That's a darn shame, isn't it?
That is insane.
Toki was breaking the little circle thing.
They need Pixay to find a drop here in order to bring this back. It's 1.2 million right now. Takedo finds a break. Pixay, you've got to hold.
Pixay holds up Fluffy, but I mean, that is a lot of combo on Lunasa, right? There's not a whole lot of back to combo, but let's continue to you. Pixay
needs to miss.
Out of the end.
Yeah, this is it.
Yes, I think it is like not no dense at all either.
Yeah, Pixay would have had to miss right there. It's going to come back a bit. It's going to be sub 1 million into the ending here. But Meijiro is massively struggling on this pick here in chalk with the dumbest miss of all time, unfortunately, in order to choke that. That actually would have been a Cowabunga win if Fluffy didn't reverse choke. Because that's 1 million score less than Pixay.
Yeah.
So Pixay coming in clutch with the only FC in the lobby. Okay, so it is a good team score to triple FC this map. Okay.
Triple FC on this is pretty. I think a triple FC on just about anything in this pool is pretty good, man.
Okay. So yeah, KBBQ coming in with a decent team score there, though. I mean, nothing bad from any other players here. 300 combo plus on that, but you know, always a little down and out there. So much potential on that pick. Did not come to fruition. Now, here's the scenario we thought was going to happen here. KBBQ getting their own pick on the board, and Cowabunga maybe getting one more chance to put one up to improve their scoreline from their first match from 5-1 to potentially 5-2.
Yeah. Gotta find a good pick to make that happen, though, to avoid the back-to-back 5-1s. This has gotta be something that's strong. It's gonna be DT3. So, well, M2U, be on the earth. Or not MTU, I'm just going to master, excuse me, MTU is DTQ. I apologize. I had the song name right, the artist wrong. After you just lost the DT... After you've lost DT4 and DT5? I don't know about picking another DT here, to be honest. Not sure about that one.
This is another map that was played last match. Much better team score from Cowabunga on this. Closer to 16 million team score here. And the reason I just mentioned that is because the maximum combo on this map is actually quite similar to Kiss Kiss, actually. Kiss Kiss is a 763 max combo. This map's max combo is like a 729, so it's pretty close. And so 16 million team score, I mean, that's a 6 million team score improvement on this from a map with technically more combo, which means that it should be easier to get a higher team score. So they're much better at this pick than they are at least some of the other DTs. And they made that last DT pretty close, so... If they're on the improvement train right here, they basically need Ophis to put up a full combo again. Ophis basically missed, like, right at the end. And then Easy Chalk had a one miss. So, you know, maybe fix that up a bit. And you've got a pretty decent team score.
I don't like the ifs, though. You hate the ifs. You know what I mean? ifs make things, you know, like, you'd rather not have to say if this happens, if that happens.
Yeah, I mean, it's a rough spot for Cowabunga regardless, right? I mean, we talked about the fact that they do literally need to win this match, no questions asked, in order to stay in because they have lost their first match. And right now, they're on the track for the same score line that we saw in the first match as well, that 5-1 potentially, if Let's Get KBBQ continues their train of being quite strong on these DT picks here. But we'll see if Cowabunga can end up picking this one up. Very interesting choice, actually, to sub out Easy Chalk, was one of their top three performers. They actually subbed out both of their hidden double time players, Chalk and Flowers, both gone for Daitaku and Ricoel.
Really great from Freddy Benson. Got a buzz slider. There's Emerald Dages on a buzz slider as well. We'll see if that was maybe Banjo. Doesn't look like it was. So, already Squishy's gone for Let's Get KBBQ. Ricoel the first to break for Cowabunga. They try desperately to stay alive, but there goes Lunasa. Nemroz follows up. It's down to just Toki now against Ophiz and Daitaku.
Interesting start on this one right here. This is pretty good for them, though, because, I mean, you have one of your players who FC'd last match still up. Nemroz finding another break, which is going to buy them a little bit more time on these combos here. Daitaku is basically just free score to match up with Freddy and Emerald Aegis right now, right? I mean, you basically take those two scores and you've got the hidden double time FC on Haitaku. But there goes Ophiz. He will not be putting up the FC again, and now Daitaku absolutely has to hold.
Yeah, this gets pretty scary now for Cowabunga because you've still got the FC on Toki. You've got the big combo on Freddy Benson with a very early break. It is a decent combo, though, on Cowabunga on all three of those members other than Ophiz. So this is going to be very slow going for the score to come back, and they might have just, like, kind of bought themselves enough time if nobody else breaks at the end here. This is coming down slowly.
It's going.
I don't know.
It's going. Oh,
it's going.
Gosh.
It's going. Is it going to go? Nemroz breaks. Nemroz breaks. It's going to prevent it from going. And Cowabunga is going to put the point up at the very last moment. Nemroz saves them from elimination with that miss at the end. And Cowabunga is alive at least one more point as the scoreline goes to 4-2.
Scoreline looks a little bit bigger now. I mean, that's a 500,000 scoreline difference between these two teams at the end there. It definitely looked like it was going closer. But that is very unfortunate for Toki, putting up that full combo and it not getting them that point. They're matched up by Daitaku, did absolutely everything that they needed to do there. Ophiz finding a tragic miss. Ricoel and Lunasa all with one miss plays on that. So great potential for that team there, and an improvement from their earlier score by quite a decent margin, a 3 million score improvement from that team. That would have won them the pick, actually, in the previous match as well, if they put up that. So, good stuff from them. They're looking better now. I mean, that's a better scoreline than their first match already.
Yeah, it's improving a bit here, but they still got to win another break point and another pick of their own just to force a tiebreaker, so it's that uphill. It's an uphill battle, you know, it gets really challenging. You gotta be locked in for multiple points in a row like that. And Let's Get KBBQ has the opportunity to close this out on their own pick now. And they've still got, I think, a couple DTs left if they want them. They've got DT 1, 2, and 6. Fremont 3 also there if they want to go that, though. The way that Nomad, was it 6 went, I don't know that I'd feel super great about Fremont 3.
I'd go for DT1 if I was KBBQ, right?
You just like DT1.
Grab that. No, I mean, genuinely.
It's actually
like,
a pretty good pick, yeah.
I do love it. You're right. I'm biased as hell, but
also, I think DT6 could be an option. Chiruchiru?
Potentially. I think Chiruchiru is maybe a little bit more accessible.
Or they just go harder for it and do something completely different.
I get this in some ways. Cowabunga double banned Hard Rock in their first match today. So if I'm on KBBQ, I'm taking one quick look at that and realizing, wow, they do not want to touch Hard Rock at all. Especially on like the even on the Hard Rock pick, they did okay, but it was Hard Rock 2, which is completely different than a precision styled Hard Rock map. And the only map that was played in their previous match that has quote unquote a precision requirement is probably like Marisa, and both of their Hard Rock players were the bottom two scoring players on their team. So, you know, you start to wonder how strong is this team really at Hard Rock, and realizing that, you know, even with one or two really good players that can put up an FC, I think you're looking pretty okay on this KBBQ.
Yeah, it's such a hard map to have a lot of consistency on. Yeah, no, I guess I'm fine with this pick, yeah. I guess it's fine.
This is fine. This is definitely fine.
Yeah, I got Jelly Chuffs out. We're going in. Let's KBBQ trying to close things out on their own pick here. You've got Taquito still playing DT. Thank you, Tournament Client.
Love it. Love the initiative, Taquito.
Alright. So Toki Taquito hidden Hard Rock. Wait. Did Taquito actually miss that whole thing?
No,
he did not.
Alright, we're good.
Thank you, Tourney Client. Again.
Toki did
does
miss.
Not like that slot. Yeah, Toki did miss, but like not missing the entire first stream.
Yeah. I mean luckily it's score V1, so. Sure, Full missed the first three streams if you think you can still win the map with PFC the rest. It will not affect you.
You'd rather not give your opponents, like, a free advantage, though.
We'll see.
Kalabunga is doing, like, okay here. They're keeping the combo. The accuracy leaves a little something to be desired, but the combo's there. And, I mean, the accuracy on Lutz and KBBQ isn't, like, amazing anyway, so.
Here comes the hard part right now, though, coming up right here. You're making it through the intro. Pez misses. Here it is. This is the section that matters right now. You've got to lock in these streams. You've got to make sure these transitions into the triples after the streams are going to be clean, too. That's really where the combos are going to start to matter here. Let's see what happens with these triples. Any miss aims on these on 6.5 are common. It looks like everyone's pretty comfortable right now, though. Not seeing anything. They make it.
Fluffy with the break. Oh, it's followed by Jantaku Helios. No.
Oh, that's a meltdown.
That's
from
so bad, Mister. You still got Okaz and Lunasa on combo, but unfortunately, the other side has Freddy Benson on NFC still and Taquito as well. Toki does break. Pez has a decent backing combo. That's going to be pretty slow to come down now because it's only the one bit of combo. It is going slowly,
it's
though.
Gonna
any
go.
Break from these FCs is going to be huge near the end here. I don't know if there's going to be time. Oh, but Okaz breaks.
That's it.
Freddy
wow,
Benson's
Taquito so
hold,
good.
Pez hold, and over it's gonna go at the very end. A shame for Kawabunga, they may have just been able to hold on, but unfortunately that last miss is gonna do it, and that's gonna settle the score, and it's gonna go, let's get KBBQ 6-2 final result.
That's it again, that was a 1 million score difference on that single miss. Kawabunga would have won that pick by about 200,000. Letting it slip away, unfortunately.
Couple of opportunities there, but man, it's like they go 5-1, then they go 5-2.
5-3 next? No.
5-3 next? Well, they
maybe 5-3 the other way?
Play the C seed next, right? That's the remaining match. I mean, I guess it's feasible.
Potentially 5-3 the other way, or 5-3. I don't know. It's potential. But
either way, that gets let's get KBBQ a win. Excuse me. So they will be heading the right direction here to get things started for themselves in this group. They are now 1-0 along with 14 UTC. Kawabunga 0-2. They are done.
They are done.
The remaining match is going to determine a lot about this group, so plenty of things to think about before next week has the remaining couple of matches in this group. And we'll see how it all goes then.
Yeah, good stuff so far from this group. We've got that's it for streams matches. Is that it for the day?
Yeah. I think there's one match left later on, but it was like a last second reschedule, and I don't really have the bandwidth to deal with it right now. So we're gonna just call it a day on this one. I think
we're gonna call it a weekend.
Yeah, we're gonna call it a weekend. We'll be back. We'll be back next Saturday. Unless we can magically find people to do stuff on Friday, I don't know that we will, because there is one match on a Friday, but otherwise we'll be back next Saturday as group stage rolls into its second of the 2 weeks. And things are gonna get serious because that's what's gonna determine these group outcomes will be next week. So definitely make sure you're following the stream, blah, blah, blah. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being here. Thank you to Chillier, our streamers, our refs, and all that jazz. And congratulations to our winners. And we'll see you guys next weekend for the second week of Pivot Cup 7 group stage. Peace out.